For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Gracious Lord, our Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this precious time you have given us to celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ and participate in the Holy Kurbana service. In this difficult time of the pandemic, we know that you are the Mighty God and you are the Prince of Peace. Help us, O Lord, to experience you more in our daily life. Help us to rededicate our lives based on this very truth, and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I welcome you all to this wonderful service of Holy Communion and Carol service. In this difficult time, we can only have a small number of gathering for Christmas service. Let us thank God for sustaining us this far. Our church choir and the junior choir has prepared beautiful carols for us. Let us begin this service by the junior choir singing Joy to the World.
Sounding joy. Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from of old, from ancient times. Therefore Israel will be abundant until the time when she who is in labor gives birth, and the rest of his brothers return to join the Israelites. He will stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they will live securely, for them his greatness will reach to the ends of the earth, and he will be their peace. When the Assyrian invades our land and marches through our fortress, we will raise against him 7 shepherds, even 8 leaders of men. They will rule the land of Assyria with the sword, the land of Nimrod with drawn sword. He will deliver us from the Assyrian when he invades our land and marches into our borders. The remnant of Jacob will be in the midst of many peoples, like dew from the Lord, like showers on the grass, which do not wait for man or linger for mankind. The remnant of Jacob will be among the nations, in the midst of many peoples, like a lion among the beasts of the forest, like a young lion among flocks of sheep, which mauls and mangles as it goes, and no one can escape. Your hand will be lifted up in triumph over your enemies, and all your foes will be destroyed. This is the word of God.
The second lesson is taken from Colossians chapter 1, verses 13 to 20. Colossians chapter 1, verses 13 to 20. For he has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of the Son he loves, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. The Son is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. For in him all things were created, things in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or powers or rulers or authorities, all things have been created through him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things hold together. And he is the head of the body and the church. Head of the body, the church. He is the beginning and the firstborn from among the dead, so that in everything he might have the supremacy. For God was pleased to have all his fullness dwell in him, and through him to reconcile to himself all things, whether things on earth or things in heaven, by making peace through his blood shed on the cross. Here ends the first and second lessons.
Light will save.
of Mary, baptized by John, have mercy on us.
Accept, O Lord, these our prayers and petitions. Make us worthy to observe in purity and goodness of heart your precepts and those of your holy apostles, and of your apostle Paul, architect and builder of your church. Amen.
From the Epistle. Galatians chapter 4 verses 1 to 7. Galatians chapter 4 verses 1 to 7. What I am saying is that as long as the heir is a child, he is no different from a slave, although he owns the whole estate. He is subject to guardians and trustees until the time set by his father. So also, when we were children, we were in slavery under the basic principles of the world. But when the time had fully come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under law, to redeem those under law, that we might receive the full rights of sons. Because you are sons, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, the Spirit who calls out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son. And since you are son, God has made you also an heir. Hallelujah, hallelujah, offer to the Lord sacrifices of praise. Come and worship in his holy courts.
Hallelujah. Give to us knowledge and discernment of your divine word. Fill us with the truth of your holy gospel, the riches of your wisdom and the gift of your spirit. Enable us gladly to obey your commands and perfectly to fulfill your holy will. Make us worthy to receive your blessings and mercies at all times, now and forever. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us stand in silence and have this.
Peace be with you.
with you all. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, which proclaimed life and salvation to the world, as recorded by the evangelist of St. Luke. In the days before the birth of Jesus the Christ, our Lord Savior, the Word of Life, God incarnate of the Blessed Virgin Mary, it happened in this way. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place with Quirinius, was governor of Syria, and everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests. Peace be with you all." O Lord, grant us your grace and your mercy. Help us, O Lord, continually to offer to you our praise and thanksgiving, to him who absolves us from our debts and pardons our sins, who receives the penitent and makes him holy, who earns for redemption of sinners and promise, "Call and I will answer, knock and I will open, and stretch forth my hands to pardon your sins." To you belong glory and honor and worship, now and forever. Let us pray to the Lord for his grace and mercy.
Yes, Lord, have mercy on us.
O Lord God, who alone can make holy, who alone can pardon and remove our sins, blot out my many great and innumerable sins and those of your people. O Lord, in your goodness have mercy on us and bless us. O Lord, remember us and our families, our bishops and clergy, and all faithful members of your holy church. Strengthen us, we pray, in body, mind and spirit. Ever refresh us with your grace and mercy. Save us from all evil and lead us, your children, to dwell with you forever. May we grow in grace and knowledge of you. To you we offer praise and thanksgiving, now and forever. Let us pray to the Lord for his grace and mercy.
Bless the Lord, have mercy and help us.
O Lord God, mighty and glorious, save us by the power from the vice of the evil one. O Lord, in your grace and mercy and love for humankind, you took flesh of the Blessed Virgin Mary and were born as man among men. Do not banish us, O Lord, from your presence and from the company of the angels. your archangels and seraphim and cherubim and all who serve and adore your holy name. Show to us the way of life and salvation, that we may persevere and attain your glorious kingdom, ever praising your goodness and bounty towards us. Lord Jesus, look upon us with the eye of your mercy. Save us from all that would hurt us and keep us in the shadow of your cross. Lord Jesus, free us from all evil and defilement, and enrich us from the treasury of your bountiful mercy. Lord Jesus, make us rejoice with all the children of your kingdom and to partake in your glory with all who have served you. And to you, to the Father, and to the Holy Spirit, we ascribe all praise and thanksgiving now and forever.
Amen.
We can, sinful as we are, let us confess and together say, Holy is the Holy Father.
Amen.
Holy is the Holy Son.
Amen.
Holy is the living and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Wisdom says aloud, let us stand in reverence and affirm together.
We believe in true God, the Father Almighty. Now those who have come prepared for birthday and wedding anniversary prayer, please come forward for the blessings. All to Jesus I surrender. Ask and it shall be given unto you. Seek and it shall find. Knock and it shall be opened unto you. Lord Jesus, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for your continuous presence in our lives, which helps us and enables us to move forward in this difficult world. Lord, you have made us worthy to be called the children of God. And we acknowledge your very purpose in each one of our lives. We commit our lives once again into your wonderful plan and ask you to guide us through for your glory. Lord, we commit these children of our parish in your mighty hands. We thank you for being with them last year. Thank you for your care and your blessings that bestowed upon each one of them. As we read in the Bible, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Lord, we ask you to help them to hold your promises and see your wonders in their lives. And we ask you to bless them. Lord, this time we especially commit those who are celebrating their birthday in your care and pray that you meet all their needs. Help them to glorify your name and witness you in their daily lives. We also pray for those couples who celebrate their wedding anniversary. Lord, thank you for uniting them amazingly. Thank you, Lord, for helping them to lead a wonderful family life. Lord, we thank you for all the blessings you have given them and uniting them according to your plan and purpose. Help them to commit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Lord, help them to love you more and serve you more as a family in the days to come. We ask this prayer in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Share these announcements. We will have the Watch Night service and Holy Communion service on 31st night 9 p.m. and also we will have a Holy Communion New Year service on January 1st morning 9 a.m. Please come prepared and glorify God. Only 50 people can attend the service and Google form will be sent to you all soon. Next Sunday, we will have ordinary service in English. Now, as we all know, 50 people can only attend the service. Please use the Google form, which will be sending you soon. And use the form and make sure that you are attending the service for the glory of God. Obituary. Miss Mary John of Hills District Prayer Group went to be with the Lord. The funeral is planned for 2:30 p.m. on Tuesday, 29 December 2020. As a parish, we cherish the memories of Srimati Mary John and we thank God for her life and involvement in the parish. She is survived by her elder sister, Dr. Elizabeth John Ammani. We, the Sydney Bethel Marthoma Church, convey our heartfelt condolences and extend our prayers to the bereaved family. Srimati Thangamma John, mother of Saji John of Western Sydney Prayer Group area, went to be with the Lord. Her funeral service was held yesterday at 3 p.m. at Muttam Shale Marthoma Church, Tumbavan. Our parish extend our condolences and extend our prayers to Saji John and family. We have a new family added to our church, Mr. Kevin P. Alexander and Akku Matthew Churail, has joined as a family in our parish. They are the members of Thiruvankulam Emmanuel Marthoma Church, Ernakulam. We welcome you both to the membership of this parish and we pray that God bless you. We will continue hearing beautiful songs of our blessed choir. The church choir and the junior choir has put an effort to bring out Christmas carol songs this year. I appreciate the choir leaders who have taken time to bring out the virtual songs. I also appreciate the technical team who have labored a lot for the production. As a church, we thank the choir, the children, the junior choir, and all the people who have been at the back for the completion of the virtual choir. And we thank you all, and let us glorify God through the singing of this carol. Now we will have the second carol, Niharam Choodu.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Again, our sincere thanks to all the choir members and all the children involved in the junior choir, and especially choir leaders Joby Varghese and John Jibin, and all other who have worked a lot with sleepless night and tiresome job. And we want to thank you all on behalf of the church. Now, three of our groups, we have seven prayer groups, and three of our groups were able to gather for Christmas carols in different places like park and in halls. And we have found and we have compiled their videos and some of the photos, and now we will be streaming that. Please watch.
Dashing through the snow, in one horse open sleigh, over fields we go, laughing all the way. Some walk in straight, making spirits bright, for fun let us to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Silent night, holy night, holy song, all is bright, round your virgin mother and child. Holy infant, so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep.
The Liverpool for finding time to have this gathering of Christmas, and it was a blessed time. So thank you all. Thank you for all those who have taken initiative for making this Christmas day a very blessed one. Thank you. Now let us pray. Lord, we thank you for your love, your compassion, your faithfulness in our lives. Thank you that we can always trust in you, and we all know that you are a mighty God, an abundant God, and you are full of grace and mercy. As we give this offering today, we worship you and give our whole selves to you. Pray that you take this offering and use it for your kingdom and for your glory. We ask this prayer in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, all the parish members and beloved in Christ, a warm greeting, especially the season greeting, the Christmas greeting to all of you. Let me also introduce our Toji Tom Varghese, who is with us today. He moved from Dubai. As a family, they are attending this service, and I welcome you as a family to this worship service. May God bless you. Thank you. A new outbreak in the northern beaches of our city has brought a latest regulation in our social meeting and religious gathering. Following the new rules, we can only accommodate 50 people for a worship service. This time, we were forced to close the Google Doc form as we have reached the maximum number 2 days back. Since we are streaming the service, it is really a blessing that all can participate online. This year we have combined the carol service and the Holy Communion service together, and we are all happy that we have this service. We know that till a proper vaccine or medicine is available, COVID-19 is an unseen troublemaker. But let us pray for a better future. We are in a difficult time, and all our Christmas celebrations, gatherings and services have got a different phase in this time of pandemic. But we know that our God is the only unchanging God. Let us stay close to our Lord Jesus Christ and worship the Lord who has taken the form of human flesh and redeemed us from our sin and become our Savior and Lord. Let me read a verse for today's meditation, Luke chapter 2. Verse 11. Luke chapter 2, verse 11. Today in the city of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. Let us bow our hearts and pray. Loving Father, the Father of our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ, we all join together in thanking you for giving us this time of worship and carol service. Help us, Lord, and enable us to hear your voice and to hear afresh and thereby magnify your mighty name. Speak to us, Lord, through the real meaning of Christmas. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Celebrations are part of our lives. It is an awesome occasion to gather with all our friends and relatives and enjoy a period of time with full of joy and happiness. Christmas is celebrated all over the world, with different intentions and emphasis. Many a times, the celebrations and festivals are done only with the intention of a get-together. In such a context, all festival seasons become a time of party, enjoyment, profit, and business. All celebrations become the same, but only with a different title. Many who consider themselves Christians believe that celebrating Christmas honors Jesus Christ, even though they celebrate it with no spiritual meaning. That is not true. As Christians, we do celebrate the birth of Christ with a different dimension. Christmas is one of the Moronai Perunal, the life and the incidents related to Jesus Christ. This means all the festivals related to the birth and life of Jesus Christ, the birth, baptism, death, Easter, Ascension, all these things in connection with Jesus Christ. So these are called Moronai Perunal and birthday of Jesus. Christmas is one among them. So we celebrate Christmas with Christ in us and Christ amongst us. When we look into the gospel accounts, it is vividly pictured that Jesus' birth was a prophetic fulfillment. The Bible is all about the salvation history of the people of God. It happens in the history of humankind. The same God who called Abraham and promised blessings is now engaged in the history in a specific historical time. The historical decree of Caesar Augustus and the census taking place are well-known facts for all of us. This decree is the proof that Jesus was born in Bethlehem at a particular time of history. So Jesus' birth in the city of David was viewed as a fulfillment of prophecy. All through the Old Testament, as I have shared, we see the prophecies of God which has come to its fulfillment in its own appointed time. We have a beautiful verse in the Bible, which lies in Galatians chapter 4, verses 4 and 5. But when the set time had fully come, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those under the law, that we might receive adoption to sonship. That is all about Christ event. That's all about Christmas. God has fulfilled the promise of the Savior in his appointed perfect time. The time was perfectly all right, politically, socially, geographically, and spiritually. And also, when we look into the passage, we can see Jesus' birth was announced to the people in need. We read that the angel's announcement was not given in a palace, or it was not given in the temple. It was given to the shepherds in the field. The angel's announcement of the fulfillment of prophecy goes not to the temple, but to shepherds living in the fields. Jesus is being born where people need him most. So let us take part in the Christmas celebration and worship service with more serious meaning and understanding of Christmas. It is an eagerness and it is an anticipation in waiting for a Messiah gives meaning and fulfillment of Christmas. Today we live in a context of crisis, agony, and uncertainty. People all over the world are in panic. The breaking news of December 23 was that the coronavirus has reached Antarctica. Now it is on every continent. So the COVID-19 pandemic has struck us with fear and anxiety. We celebrate Christmas in 2020 in this fearful context. Let us understand the meaning of Christmas as the shepherds in the field heard the announcement of joy and salvation. The news that demands a response. So the people heard the news, the shepherds heard the news, we also heard the news of Jesus' birth. What is next? What comes after the birth announcement? What do we do now that we have been told that the Christ has been born, wrapped in bands of cloth and is lying in a manger? There is only one thing to do. Go and see. Go and see. It is one thing to hear about the birth. It is another to see it, experience it, take it in and make it a part of our lives. That's what this morning and the Advent season is all about. That's what today's gospel, Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 20, is all about. Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, the shepherds said to one another. Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place. Good news of great joy always demands a response. It asks us to go and see. That's what the shepherds did, and that's what we must do today. Today we go to Bethlehem. Bethlehem, however, is not just a physical place. Today Bethlehem is more than a geographical location in Israel. It is within us. It is a spiritual reality in the hearts of every human being. Bethlehem is situated amidst hope and joy, sorrow and loss, conflict and chaos, healing and reconciliation, cruelty and violence, peace and justice. It is a place, everyone, it is a place in our hearts, in everyone's heart. If you don't go to Bethlehem and see the child lying in a manger of our lives, the good news of great joy announced by the angel is just an information. And Jesus' birth is just another historical fact. What do we need today? We don't need more facts and information. We don't need more facts and information. We need meaning in our lives. We need to make meaning of the child lying in the manger and allow him to give meaning to our lives. The meaningful celebration takes place only when we allow ourselves for his spiritual birth that should happen in our lives, in our hearts, in our souls. Christmas Day asks us to move from the fact of Jesus' birth to the meaning of his birth. What does this birth mean for your life and my life? What do our lives look like now in light of this birth? How does this birth is going to change our lives? Jesus' birth in each of our lives is as unique and particular as is each of our lives. Today's gospel doesn't tell us what is the meaning is all about, but it does, however, gives a couple of clues about how to discover and make meaning of Jesus' birth in our lives. The shepherds and Mary are guidelines. They are guiding us in this search for meaning of Jesus' birth in our lives. We read in verses 16 to 18 and 20, chapter 2 of St. Luke. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherd said to them. Verse 20, the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. So for the shepherds, the life after returning was a life renewed. After seeing the angel, after seeing Jesus Christ at the manger, they were able to change their lives. The angel's announcement of Jesus' birth interrupted the lives of the shepherds. It called them away from their field and watching their flock. They went to Bethlehem to find the child lying in a manger. The good news of joy is announced in the ordinary, everyday circumstances of our lives too. It happens in our fields while we are watching our flocks. We need the sharing of the good news happening in our fields. What are your particular field and folks, family, friends, professional space and ups and downs of life, frustrations and celebrations, joy and sorrows, illness and health? Christmas, however, is not an escape from our field and flock. What did the shepherds do after they saw the child lying in the manger? They returned. They returned to the same field and with the same flock. The birth that interrupted and called the shepherds away from their field and flock is also the birth that returned them to their field and flock. They spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, Jesus Christ. They returned to the same field and the same flock. Their field and flock were not different, but they were the same. They carried the birth of Jesus within them back to their field and flock. So it was a life renewed. So shepherd returned glorifying and praising God. That's where we will express the experience of the meaning of Jesus' birth in our lives. Therefore, my dear friends, let us go back to our respective places with a renewed mind. Let us share the gospel. Let us share the good news that we have seen Christ in the manger. We have Christ in our hearts. Secondly, when we look into the life of Mary, for Mary, it was finding meaning in a stormy life. Luke chapter 2, verse 19, it says, "But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart." Let's look into the description of Jesus' birth and the shepherd's visitation. The Blessed Virgin Mary has something marvelous to tell us. She has much to teach us here. Notice what she says in today's gospel. She says nothing. She says nothing. Instead, St. Luke tells us she treasured and pondered. Perhaps that's how we begin to make meaning of Jesus' birth in our lives. Pondering and treasuring. Making meaning is not so much about explaining and understanding or analyzing. It is all about wondering, musing, discovering. It is not about finding the answer. There is no one single answer or meaning of Jesus' birth. There are as many meanings as there are fields and flocks, the circumstances of our lives. Therefore, my dear friends, let us ponder, let us meditate upon the life of Jesus, the whole meaning of Christmas, the whole meaning of Christ coming to the earth, God became flesh. Silent treasuring and pondering seems to be the way of Mother Mary. Can they also be our way? What do you treasure about Jesus' birth? What treasure does his birth hold you for? What does your pondering reveal about him, you and your life together? How would you look? How would your life look, be different and be changed if you carried Jesus' birth within you back to your field and flocks? The child has been born wrapped in field in bands of cloth and in lying in a manger. Leave your fields and flocks for some time, treasure and ponder. Then return to your field and flocks. It will reveal the meaning of Jesus' birth in our lives and make meaning of our lives. He comes to bless and banish pain. He comes to break the captive's chain. That is our Savior. Sometimes the incident happens in our lives makes us more confusing and challenging. We are God's children, but there are times of struggle of life and physical diseases and pain. But Mary, through meditating and pondering, was able to make the connection with all that happened in her life. Just look into the life of Mary and Joseph. They had vision of a Savior's birth, but they had to go through their life with fear and anger many times. Mary sang praises and followed a revelation, searching for something new, something beyond herself. But they were close the doors of life and saw hang, no vacancy sign. They have offered shelter to and been guardians of the baby Jesus, but they have known times when they were homeless. We have been welcomed as the providers of good news, and we have also felt like an outcast. We have planned our future and we are grieved its loss. Christmas is our story. Let us connect the dots of our life and worship the Lord. He is still the Almighty God, even in times of uncertainties and crisis. So let us ponder, let us meditate, let us think about the whole meaning of Christmas. Finally, therefore, my dear friends, let us go and participate. We cannot come to the manger empty-handed. To come to the manger with nothing is to come as spectators of history. To bring our own life to the manger is to come as participants in Christ's birth. Spectators might see God's Son born in Bethlehem, but participants will experience God's Son born in themselves. That is the difference. That is what I want to share with you today. That is what I want to happen in my life, in your life, and in the life of the whole world. After all, what does it matter if Jesus was born in those days in that region, if he is also been born in these days in this region, in our lives and soul? Therefore, Jesus is for us today as our Savior and Lord. Let us go there and see him. Let us worship him and let us give our present. Let us dedicate our lives. Let us rededicate our lives and soul. Let us also surrender our lives as our gifts to the Savior Jesus. Let us come back to our social situation and carry the good news to our neighborhood. He is the Savior of the whole world. Let us also ponder and discover the new meaning and purpose of our life. Don't be afraid of things that happens in your life. If you are called by God for a purpose, He works all things together for the glory of God. If you think and meditate, you can connect the dots in your lives. So let us not be mere spectators, but let us be participants of Christ even Christmas. May God bless us all. Once again, wishing you all a blessed day of Christmas. Thank you all. God bless you. Let us close our eyes and let us pray.
Gracious and Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for giving us this blessed time as a church to observe and celebrate the real meaning of Christmas, Lord. Lord, in midst of this uncertainty and pandemic situation, Lord, you have given us few of the members, Lord, to assemble here to praise you and to worship you, Lord. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for this privilege that you have given us, Lord. Lord, especially, Lord, when we remember your birth, Lord, Lord, help us, Lord, to accept that it is for our salvation that you have to come to this world as a human being. Lord, you showed us how to live according to the law that was given to Moses. And you showed us, Lord, our Father, how to love others, Lord. Lord, you died for our sins, for our salvation, to redeem us, Lord. Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, through that great atonement and through our belief in that, Lord, we have been adopted as a son and daughters of the Heavenly Father. Lord, your love is unconditional. Your mercy is limitless. And your work is unstoppable, Lord. Lord, you are still working in us. You are refining us. And in that process, Lord, we have to face many challenges, Lord. Lord, help us, Lord, to understand that all these challenges and tough times in our life is to develop us so that, Lord, we are made according to your purpose, Lord. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the message that we heard through our action. Lord, as indicated, Lord, help us, Lord, to share your love to our neighbors, Lord. Lord, we have been called for that very great purpose, Lord. Lord, the mission that was started by you, was carried by your disciple, Lord, now the mission is with us to be continued, Lord. Lord, when we see, Lord, our Father, the faith in people has come down, Lord, and we are solely responsible for that, Lord. Because, Lord, the believers stopped declaring praises, declaring your glory, Lord. Lord, help us, Lord, to stand firm and boldly so that we will share your message of love, your gospel, so that many will be added to witness you, Lord. Lord, this Christmas, Lord, help us, Lord, to understand the true meaning, the purpose, the very purpose that you have come for us, Lord. And that, Lord, you will come again, Lord, and will add us all into your kingdom, Lord. Heavenly Father, especially, Lord, throughout this year, Lord, we have gone through a tough and challenging time, Lord. Lord, we believe in your promise that you will never leave us and never forsake us, Lord. More than in vaccine and medicine, Lord, we believe in you, Lord, our Father. You are the complete healer, Lord, our Father. Lord, heal the creation that you have made, Lord Abba. The creation urge, Lord Abba, Father. The believers, non-believers, Lord, everyone, Lord Abba, Father, is seeking for healing, Lord Abba, Father. And Lord, only your mercy can heal, Lord Abba. Lord, we pray for your mercy, Lord. Lord, we pray, Lord Abba, Father, for the remainder part of this service. Help us, Lord, to meaningfully partake, Lord, in the Holy Communion service. Lord, we give you all glory and honor to you. In Jesus' matchless name we pray. Amen.
Okay, let us thank God and praise Him for enabling us to participate in this Holy Communion service and the carol service together. At the end of the service, we will have a vote of thanks by our secretary, Abraham G. George. And we also have cake sharing. Christmas cake has been arranged. So please partake in the sharing of the joy of Christmas. So when we come for the Holy Kurbana service, please accept the blessed body in the right palm, keeping your left palm underneath, and also thankfully receive the blessed blood of Jesus Christ from the cup, and that cup will be collected later by the lay assistants. We will not have kiss of peace as we usually have before. We will only have the prayer of kiss of peace. Thank you. Now those who have come prepared for participating in the Holy Communion service, please stand up where you are and follow this prayer of confession after me. I confess that I have sinned against you, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, in thought, word, and deed. I am sorry with all my heart for these my sins. I believe in your promise that you will receive those who truly repent. O Lord, who are merciful and full of grace, accept me as you accept the publican, the woman who was a sinner, and the thief on the cross, and comfort me by the consolation of your word. O Lord, grant that your holy body and holy blood, in which I now partake, may not bring me to judgment and condemnation, but to life and wholeness. Amen. God Almighty, be compassionate to you who have truly confessed your sins and freely forgive your sins, and make you all worthy to partake in this Holy Communion. Amen.
O God and Lord of all, make us
worthy to greet one another with a kiss of peace. Free from insincerity and united in love to you, O Father, and your only Son, and your Holy Spirit, we ascribe praise and glory now and forever. Amen. Peace be with you all. May the love and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ abide with us forever. Brothers, merciful Lord, you dwell on high, condescend to look upon things that are lowly. Bless now those who have bowed their heads in your presence, and bless them with the grace of your only Son, with whom and with the Holy Spirit you are worthy of all praise and glory, now and forever. The love of God the Father, the grace of our only begotten Son, and the communion and abiding presence of the Holy Spirit be with you all, dearly beloved, forever. May our hearts be with Christ on high. Sing praises and worship the Creator of all things, who is adored by the heavenly hosts, sun and moon and all the stars, the earth and seas and all that dwells there, angels and archangels, thrones and powers, cherubim and seraphim ever proclaiming, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna. When the sinless one of his own will chose to suffer death for us sinners, he took bread in his holy hand. He gave thanks, blessed, sanctified, and broke it and gave it to his apostles, saying, take it, this is my body given for you, this do in remembrance of me. In the same way, he took the cup. He gave thanks, blessed, sanctified, and gave it to his apostles, saying, drink this, all of you. This is my body of the new covenant, which is shed for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. O Lord, we remember your death, burial, and resurrection, your ascension into heaven, and your presence now with God the Father in glory and in power. We await your coming again to judge the world in righteousness and truth. Therefore, we, your people, offer to you, O Lord, this sacrifice and service, and entreating you and through you, your Father, not to do deal with us according to our sins, but according to your own abundant mercy, and saying, answer unto us, O Lord, answer unto us, O Lord, answer unto us, O Lord, and by your grace of mercy on us. Lord, have mercy. May the Holy Spirit sanctify this bread that may be the body of our Lord Jesus Christ. May the Holy Spirit sanctify the wine in this chalice that it may be the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Sanctify, O Lord, the bodies and souls of those who receive these gifts, that they may bear fruit for the stability of your holy church. Establish ever more firmly your church founded on the rock of faith, against which the gates of hell shall not prevail, and persevere her to the end from strife and error. To you, with the Son and the Holy Spirit, she will offer praise and thanksgiving both now and forever. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, we remember the mother of our Lord, the Blessed Virgin Mary, who is worthy to be blessed of all generations of the earth. All the mighty holy prophets, the apostles, the preachers, the evangelists and the martyrs, the confessors and all the saints, make us worthy, O Lord, to follow in their footsteps.
Lord, have mercy. Blessing of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ be with you all. Let us continue in our prayers. We have come to the last month of this year. By God's grace, we are all able to celebrate the birth of Christ, the Christmas, once again in our lives. You know, we all have been going through a very difficult time. Let us remember the lakhs of people passed away because of this pandemic. Many people are going through very difficult situations. Let us ask for God's grace and mercy. Let us pray God, pray to God that God may heal the world. We have the promise of God. It says, nothing bad will happen to you, no disaster will come to your home. Let us claim all God's promises that we see in the Word of God. Let us meditate upon God's plan in our lives. Let us go back into a situation and praise the Lord and convey the gospel of Christ. Let us remember all the churches across the world for their effective mission work.
Let us thank God for the leaders of the church. And may God enable them and empower them and anoint them with new spirit that they may continue their ministry for the glory of God. Let us remember all our elderly people. Let us remember the family of Mary John. Let us thank God for her life. Let us pray for the blessed conduct of the funeral service. Let us also remember Saji John and his family. Let us remember all our parents, all our kin, relatives, friends, all over the world. Some of them are going through this difficult pandemic situation. Let us remember and ask God for God's intervention and God's healing touch upon each one of their lives. Let us thank God for our choir, the junior choir and our church choir. God has enabled them to produce all these songs. We were able to produce 5 virtual songs during this pandemic time. So let us thank God for their service and their commitment and their love for the Lord. Let us remember all our prayer group, all the members of our parish. Let us commit our lives for the glory of God and ask God to help us to participate in this Christmas services and in the Holy Communion service with thanksgiving and with love towards the Almighty God. Let us pray for a church construction project. Let us pray for all our different needs and personal needs. We have a good God. We have a good Heavenly Father who is able to take care of all our lives and needs. So let us thank God for Him. O God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, glorified by the cherubim, extolled by the seraphim, and exalted by all the heavenly host, who make holy the offering and oblation presented before you, sanctify our bodies, souls, and spirit, that with pure and confident heart we may address you as God the Father and pray, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, may your kingdom come,
may your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day the bread we need, and forgive us our sins and offenses, as we have forgiven those who offended us. Do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen. Peace be with you all.
And with you also. The Lord and God of every blessings, we bow our heads in your presence. Before we receive your holy body and blood.
May the grace and mercy of the holy and glorious Trinity, uncreated, self-existent, eternal, adorable, and one in essence, be with you all forever.
And with you also, O Holy and Glorious Trinity, have mercy on us.
Holy things for holy people.
Holy is the one Father, holy is the one Son, holy is the one Spirit.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
One from the beginning, and forever and ever.
The one Holy Father who created the world in His mercy is with us.
Amen.
The one Holy Son who served by His precious passion is with us.
Amen.
The one living Holy Spirit who perfects and fulfills all that is and that has been is with us. May the name of the Lord be blessed as in the beginning, both now and forever.
Amen.
beloved brothers and sisters, pray for me.
As the Father has compassion on his children, the Lord has pity on those who fear him.
As for man, his days are like grass, he flowers like the flowers of the field.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. Amen. When your living voice awoke from the graves, your servants who have departed this life in trust and hope in you, then, O Lord, remember us.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, grant that we may rejoice with all those who have done your will and hear your gracious words. Come and inherit the kingdom with the saints.
Glory be to the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Lord, at your command death held its way. You rose from the dead, and death was abolished. Therefore, O Lord, we praise and exalt. O Lord, every mouth shall sing your praise. You gather your children from every quarter. Bless us and help us. We pray you, O Lord.
O Son of God, by your deal, incident of death and life, raise us from the dust, we may proclaim your praise. May God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit,
who is worthy of glory and worship forever, be praised from generation to generation.
Hallelujah. O Son of God, who came for our salvation and will come again for our resurrection, and for the renewal of our race, grant, we pray, forgiveness of sins to your servants through your own atoning sacrifice.
Amen.
O Lord God, graciously bless these your children who partake of your most precious body and blood, which was given on Calvary for the forgiveness of sins, that they may abide in your presence forever. The blessing of Jesus Christ, our great God and Savior, on those who bear these sacred mysteries, on those who dispense them, and those who receive them, and on all those who have participated, and who shall participate in them, the grace of God be with us all, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord, be gracious and have mercy on us.
Glory and praise be to you, Lord. Praise be to you, our everlasting refuge.
The holy body and holy blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, broken and shed on the cross of Calvary for forgiveness of our sins, is given for your health of your body and your soul.
Thank you.
is fit, so rule and love for me.
features glad for me. Let me hide myself in thee. Let the water and the blood from the riverside which flowed be of sin the double cure. Cleanse me from this guilt and pall. Not the labor of my hands can fulfill thy law's demands. Could my zeal no respite know, could my tears forever flow, all for sin could not atone. Thou must save and thou alone.
Let us praise the Lord. Praise be to you, O Lord, our God forever. Praise be to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. May your holy body and blood of which we have partaken be not for our condemnation, but for life and salvation to us all. O God, grant us your blessings. We praise you, O Lord, because in your abundant mercy you have fed and strengthened us with the precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and you have thereby made us one with him and with all the members of his mystical body. We pray you to give us grace to continue in that holy fellowship and forever to offer glory and praise to you and to your only begotten Son and to your Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you all.
And be with you also. O Lord our God,
source of all blessings, we bow our heads before you, having received your holy body and blood.
O great and wonderful God, who for salvation of mankind stoop down and descend from heaven, have mercy on us and bless us, so that we may continually praise you and the Father and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Bless us, O Lord Almighty. You are our God, the Creator. Show to us ever the way of salvation. Our God, helper of all.
O Lord, bless this your servant, who has ministered in your presence. Accept praises and petitions of us, your people, and pardon us our offenses. Enable us to receive your gifts and blessings, and send us with your peace.
My beloved brothers and sisters, I commend you to the grace and blessings of the Holy and Glorious Trinity. Depart now in peace with the gifts and blessings that you have received from the atoning sacrifice of our Lord.
Amen.
You both far and near who are saved by the victorious cross of the Lord and sealed with the seal of holy baptism, this Holy Trinity will forgive your sins and comfort your souls.
Amen.
Pray for me, my brothers and sisters, weak and sinful as I am, that I may obtain mercy and help, depart in peace, filled with gladness and rejoicing.
Thanks be to God. May the Lord accept your ministration and help us by your prayers.
In Now the vote of thanks by the secretary.
Wish you all a Merry Christmas. We take this opportunity to thank each and every choir member who participated in the virtual singing. Our sincere gratitude to Bijoy to accompany the junior choir. Santosh, as usual, has spent a number of sleepless nights compiling this. We thank Santosh and Joel for the vocals. For the video presentation, we thank Sibin, Jacob Thomas, Jibin, and Nino. This has been a tough year for the choir. However, they have accomplished excellent multiple virtual songs. Our gratitude to Joby to lead the choir in these difficult times. We also thank Bini and the technical team to stream all the services since the pandemic started in March. Wish you all Merry Christmas again, and join us for the Christmas cake after the service in the hall.
Once again, wishing you a very blessed Christmas and a happy new year. God bless us all.